I wish we had a more compelling reason for why we chose this cover story, save for the fact that this was just such a fun idea. But I think what really pushed us to do an Indian version was Edvard Munch's The Scream, which the rendition was in toast and cream cheese, red and yellow bell peppers and celery stalks. And as we started on the project, we also came across Caitlin Freeman's book, Modern Art Desserts, which had a Piet Mondrian cake and an Andy Warhol gelée. The only trouble we faced with Ganesh Payan was deciding which Ganesh Payan to go with. Payan's prime concern is death, and skulls and bones are repeated motifs across several of his canvases. And there's a tale behind that. We figured the teeth was a great, if slightly morbid, example of his oeuvre. And we also thought that the way the solemnity of the piece squares off with the medium, which is chocolate, was pretty cute. Crabgrass by Aparajita and Adimulam, I'm aware, was a slightly unusual pick. But it is one of my favorite pieces from the feature because it allowed an ingredient to play itself. The two crabs here are not mimicking a line or a shade or a texture. They're playing crabs. And the Indian salmon, which is playing the sea, was just Nitin's masterstroke, with its natural shading that sat really well with the original piece. Saurashtra by S.H. Raza was a natural choice. Even 3 years after it was sold at a Christie's sale in 2010, Raza remains our priciest artist. And as it turned out, Saurashtra was the most labor-intensive, mammoth piece we did in this entire feature. It took 2 whole days to put together and was never quite finished, even until 2 minutes before the shoot. I know we could have gone with a simpler Raza with the distinctive mandalas and bindus, and the geometric lines would have been easier to assemble than the diffuse daubs of Saurashtra. But we are glad Time Out Now owns a version of the most expensive modern Indian artwork ever sold. I think Bharti Kher is one of our most important contemporary artists, and not merely because of the 7 crore price tag that got yoked to her mammoth sculpture. The skin speaks a language not its own. She has developed a language, picks up on fine themes, and there is a certain hypnotic quality associated with the thousands of bindis that are tacked onto this sculpture. I was a little hesitant about this piece only because we had to make sure the molding and the proportions were perfect. But Nitin and his team were very sure-footed about their approach. We attempted to get a fair mix of artists, of men and women, contemporary and modern. Unfortunately, the male to female ratio is 2:7, but I want to make a small point about this. Several women artists that we sorely wanted to be a part of the feature, like Arpita Singh, Nilima Sheikh, and Mithu Sen, had such complex and complicated works that we were really intimidated about pulling them off. And the ones that we eventually went with, which is the Amrita Shergill canvas and the Bharti Kher sculpture, were really the hardest to execute. Jamini Roy was a definite shoo-in because everyone at Time Out loves him. And he's also one of the few Indian artists whose style is immediately recognizable to a viewer who hasn't taken a course in art history or walked across the National Gallery of Modern Art. One of the things we learned and struggled with throughout the feature, and it is especially evident in this piece, was that there are no natural blues in food, and we did not want to repeat mayonnaise and food coloring. So for the metallic grayish background, dill leaves had to serve the purpose. Amrita Shergill remains one of our most enigmatic women artists. She had an insider-outsider location, was of ambivalent sexuality, and she died very young. This selfie is believed to be inspired by Paul Gauguin's Portraits of Tahitian Women, but that's where the inspiration ends. I mean, just look at her poise and self-assurance. This piece made us really nervous, and we struggled for days to see how best to execute it. But then Nitin found a reference in a Simon Cowell portrait on toast, and then suddenly, everyone fell in love with the idea. And it might have made our lives easier had we chosen a flatter Shergill canvas like, say, Brahmachari's. But once we saw it all come together, we really couldn't complain. It was then a matter of finding a stylist and a photographer who could share the same vision. And we were really glad we found Nitin Tandon and his team who styled the artworks, and Mihir Hardikar who shot the whole feature. Because we were all on the same page about the project. This is art as food as art. Somewhere along the way, we were also hoping, without sounding completely presumptuous about this, that this would be Time Out's tiny educational tour through a fraction of Indian art.